Hello, this is so awesome. We can make videos now. This is a video response to Chekhov Studio London. They were talking about the psychological gesture, and that's wonderful. I just wanted to add a couple of things because I'm so excited about the psychological gesture. It is so great for so many different purposes. For instance, like and described in the previous video, it can be used in discovering the character's archetype, the very essence of the character, the reason they were born into being, their very essence in the script, in the story, the things that they do, not the things they say, not the things other people say about them, but the things, the actions they take, the things they will do throughout the story. In a way, they're super objective. The other wonderful thing about the psychological gesture and objective is that actors are often pretty good in finding their objectives. Like, they intellectually understand what the character's objective is. But at times, there seems to be a little disconnect between from understanding the objective and intellectually to getting the objective to live in the actor's body, to viscerally be and live in the need and want and wish and desire of the character. So psychological gesture is a fantastic way of getting the character's objective to live in the actor's body, which by then has transformed, hopefully through the imaginary body exercises already, to be the character's body. So psychological gesture is a fantastic tool for that. It's also great for just even getting a book, using the speech gestures, and I can talk about those, and Sarah Kane is like a master teacher in this, so she should make a video about the speech gestures, the six of them. What else? Yeah, well, this is a little bit of something that I wanted to add, and well, let's continue talking about the technique and the atmospheres and the qualities of movement, and there's so many things to discuss. And a lot more to discuss about the psychological gesture as well, because when you found the gesture, after that comes the very very specific how of each character, because my character could pull somebody, tear somebody apart tenderly, and what kind of tender is their tender. So that's another fun thing to, when you discover your objective, then you also will discover how this particular specific human being goes after the objective. Hooray! Let's talk more soon. And another thing I just have to add about the psychological gesture is that when we rehearse it and we are exploring and discovering the gesture, it's full. You do the gesture with your whole being, which means with your whole body, with your whole energy field, with your, like we like to say, energy body or life body, with your breath. It's important to fully commit to this, not just with your outer body, but with your inner energy body as well, with your breath. So this is how it's rehearsed. There's a beginning, middle, and end to it, and it's good to start it from the polar opposite. So, and I have these things on, so I can't really show anything right now, but we can. If you don't know what this means, send a question, and I'll show you how. The other thing that I really want to talk about is that, so when we rehearse the gesture, it is an outer and inner movement. But by the end of the rehearsal, the psychological gesture is an inner gesture. That's why it's called psychological. So let's say in a film, in a close-up shoot, there might be no outer gesture, no outer movement at all in the character, in the actor. But the actor is filled with the inner gesture, the inner movement, the direction of the energy. You could be inwardly pulling someone towards you, and then the quality, you could do it tenderly, you could do it violently, you could inwardly be pushing somebody away. This is where all the beauty that's seen on close-ups really comes to comes to fruition. I don't know if that's a word. I make up words now. Just had to add that. And one more thing about the psychological gesture. It is the subtext, the inner truth of the character. Sometimes there's a misunderstanding that the actor would ask from me. So, but in this moment, the character is hiding the inner truth, and this is true. We often, just like us, the characters will wear social masks, and they're hiding, they're veiling their true desires and feelings. However, the psychological gesture is there to fill you with the truth, the real visceral sensation of the wish, the desire, the need and want of the character. And after you are filled with it continuously, it's not like a steady thing, it's a movement, it's a gesture in movement. The energy is moving towards the wish and need and want. After that, then of course the character can veil it and hide it, but it first has to be there. So the psychological gesture is not a gesture of hiding. It's like theater mask. It's there to bring the soul out, not to hide. Veiling is something else. We'll talk about veiling later.